Still right judgment. And it's not easy, because using your gifts sometimes means being courageous. Say you're in a situation now and somebody's being treated badly. Say somebody in your class or somebody you know is being made feel they're not wanted, or is being bullied, made a laugh of, and you know they're feeling miserable. The courageous thing is to say, I don't want to be any part of that. I don't agree with this. But it is courageous, because if you do it, they might start making a laugh of you as well. But it takes courage. It takes generosity to look around and to see people who need you. Somebody who needs a friend, somebody who's worried, somebody who's sick, somebody who's anxious about something, somebody who feels lonely. And sometimes, just when somebody needs you, you have other things to be doing. So it takes a bit of generosity. It's demanding. So you're coming and you're making the promise this time. You're making the promise that you will try and use your gifts. It's not that you can solve every problem in the world. When you look around and you see all the hunger in the world and all the boys and girls like you that don't have houses to live in and don't have enough food to eat and don't have a doctor to take care of them when they're sick. And you can't solve all those problems. But what you can do is to say to yourself, have I gifts that I could use? Could I use them to help somebody? And because that's a big challenge, that's why all the people who are here with you today, and lots of them were here with you on the other big days, they're here saying, we're going to go on encouraging you. We're going to go on praying for you. We're going to go on trying to show you how to use your gifts. And that's really our prayer for all of you today, that you will be people who use your gifts generously and wisely and well. Amen.
Believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead and is now seated at the right hand of the Father.
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles of Pentecost and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
So if you kneel down now, please, and we pray for the girls and boys who are about to be confirmed. And your friends in baptism, God our Father gave the new birth of eternal life to these his chosen sons and daughters. Let us pray to our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen his sons and daughters with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, Son of God. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you. We pray for all of us confirmed today by the gift of the Spirit, that we may give witness to Jesus Christ by lives built on faith and love. Lord, hear us. We pray for our parents and sponsors, that they may always encourage us to follow Christ for the whole of our lives. Lord, hear us. For the church, that the Holy Spirit may gather us together in unity and love. Lord, hear us. We pray for the people of every race and nation, that they may live in justice and harmony, seeking the peace and joy which the Holy Spirit brings. Lord, hear us.
Grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Peace is one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Let us offer each other now a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
This is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper.
Thank you.
finish, I say thank you to all the people who provided the music and the singing. Thank you very much. And the people who did readings and prayers of the faithful, and the offered a procession and brought up symbols, and everybody who took part in the ceremony, and everybody who was part of preparing the girls and boys for their confirmation, the teachers, of course, and for even longer than the teachers, of mothers and fathers and families who have been preparing you. And perhaps most important of all, congratulations to the boys and girls themselves. We're going out now to use your gifts. And I say now, it began to have great ideas in your heads about what you'll do with your gifts when you're 18, but what about today? You might find a chance to, is there somebody you could be especially kind to today? Is there somebody you could say thank you to today? Is there somebody you could say sorry to today? Is there somebody who isn't here that you could get in touch with and tell them all about it? There are all sorts of ways you might think of somebody else today. And I might just also mention that on a confirmation day, girls and boys sometimes get other gifts, as well as the gifts of the Holy Spirit. They might be kind of rich. When you were learning all about the people in the world who are starving, did you ever say to yourself, you know, rich people should do something about that? And guess who'll be rich today? I'm not saying you should give everything away, but one of the things you might think of when you're rich is to maybe think of some little donation that you would give to Boher or Troker or Vincent de Paul, or some way that you might use your gifts, even those gifts, use them to help other people. It's all a challenge, but it's a challenge, it's a very important challenge, and that's why at the end of our Mass we ask God now to bless all of us, but especially to bless the girls and boys who have just been confirmed. And I never said thanks to the altar service. Thank you very much, and of course to Father Oliver. The Lord be with you. Let us pray for God's blessing. God our Father made you his children by water and the Holy Spirit. May he bless you and watch over you with his fatherly love. Amen. Jesus Christ, the Son of God, promised that the Spirit of truth would be with his church forever. May he bless you and give you courage in proclaiming the true faith. Amen. The Holy Spirit came down upon the disciples and set their hearts on fire with love. May he bless you and keep you one in faith and love and bring you to the joy of his kingdom. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
And hell. us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be.